Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, it's Keith from KME's Corner. How are you doing today? We are in episode number 23. We have drained the water temple, and we got to work on the farm that I'm going to make with the water temple, but we're going to stay away from the water temple today because, you know, I spent so much time there, you know, you need a little break. But I brought some stuff back with me from the water temple, yes. And ever since the very first day I made this room, I've been wanting to do this. Yes. I don't want no stinking glowstone in my ceiling. I want this. Looks so much better. In this room, in my head, when I designed it, I did not want glowstone. I wanted these whitish green lights of joy. That's what you want to call them. Lights of joy down here. I don't know if I'm going to replace these with lights of joy, but glowstone used to be my light of joy, but since guardian temples and stuff were made, these are lights of joy, especially with packed ice. I mean, this looks so great with packed ice that I can't imagine glowstone ever being in here. So, yeah, ever since I put this packed ice on my ceiling down here in my initial small storage room, I've been chomping at the butt for this day so I can go like this and replace this glowstone. Yes. So, yes. Oh my gosh. Much better. Much better. So, of course, we gotta figure out if it looks good here. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Sorry. Still love you, glowstone. A lot of people don't love glowstone, but I love glowstone. The main thing I think this game is missing is a whole bunch of light. There should be even maybe this design of light, and if you add a different color dye to it, you can dye the light, you know, green, red, orange, yellow, whatever color you want. I don't like having two sources of lights for lighting up the world. I'll take it. I mean, the glowstone is going to stay down there just because I don't have a shit ton of these, whatever they're called. What are they called? Sea lanterns. My favorite light source in the game, and I don't know what they're called. So, in the last episode, I kind of showed you the progress I was making. I finished the water temple. I basically dug four different colors of stained clay to fill up double chests full. And I got those all completed and all that just because I have a lot of extra time right now. So I'm going to do a lot of menial tasks. I am going to do some more caving so I can get some more of these blocks because I need a shit ton of those for my project I have in my head for the future. But I've also done some other stuff while I was doing the other video. And that video that I had last time with all the fast forwards and me just talking over it right after the surgery was basically to show you that this pickaxe, which is my Siltouch pitch, which is going to be my work pick because it's got the efficiency 5 on breaking 3, and the important thing is mending. So this pick will never die. I just need to get XP into it and it will be all good. So basically the last episode I showed you all the digging I did. I went through this pick 5 times and 4 or 5 times. I'm not 100% sure if I made it to the 5th time in the video or if it was after the video was done I made it. And I brought it down, the durability down to under 100, under 50 most of the times. And then going to the mob spawner was able to bring the pick back. That is awesome, because if I were to try and repair this in an anvil, let's see. It would probably be a shit ton of levels if I can. It's already too expensive. I can't fix this pick in an anvil at all. But I can mend it using XP, which makes the mending enchant the biggest possible changer in this game in a long time. So I'm really, really happy about that. So what I have been doing, I'm going to have to show you now, and it culminated this morning. I've been doing this for a couple of weeks, ever since episode like 20-something, but I've been kind of keeping it hidden, just because I've done so much of this work on cam before. Well, let's just show the whole thing from the beginning. You guys seen this spawner for villagers, but I don't think you saw the tube that brought it down here, and that's where the villagers end up going. So that tube has been completed. So what I've been doing is going through the villagers, taking the ones out I like, and so the ones I like I have chained up against the wall. This will change. This is just temporary. And the ones I don't like, I made a platform in the middle and I held them all in place and to fill up for a certain other thing which I have made, which I am showing off there in the distance. That is an iron golem farm. And so the first 20 villagers that I did not like ended up in the iron golem farm. And ever since then, when I get villagers I don't like, I kill them now. Because I want a nice economy. And that's what I'm working on here, is a nice economy. But these villagers, initially, mommy and daddy, were 1.8 villagers. And from the 1.8 villagers, I got a baby that gave me Frostwalker, which gave me hope, because that is a 1.9 enchant. I'm like, yes. And I have to say, I went through a couple hundred villagers, but this morning, I did not find a Depth Strider. I found the Mending Villager. Now I can get Mending Books whenever I want. That is, oh my effing god, unbelievable. That is incredibly crazy. That is a game changer. I mean, now the game's too easy. I can do whatever I want. The game's done. I won. Yep. Good game. End of series. All done. So that means I'm going to put mending on my overwhelming armor of destiny. So I am all done with villagers. I'm going to go through, because there's a couple of enchants that I would like to get better. But one thing I noticed is in the past with villagers, let's see, you could go like this. Actually, you know what I used to do? I like to get them from the side. Oop. Just come out of there. So I used to get them like this. And you throw a minecart down. And you could brush up against a villager and it would pick up the villager. But now, minecarts don't do that. Even if you push the villager into it. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Let's kill my villagers while I'm at it. But anyways, so they don't go into minecarts anymore. And I had a whole bunch of them out here. And I'm like, how the hell am I going to get them transported to that farm? So one thing you could do, I'll just demonstrate it real quick. You say this is your floor. You have something like this. And the villagers are on this floor. You could cut out there and there. Put a couple of tracks there and put a stopper right here. And put a cart right here. Whoops, how did that not happen? You could put a cart right here. And if this was your floor and you had the villager up here, you can push falling in, and with the cart moving, that would suck them up. But for some reason, I don't think the computer really likes that. Because when I get them in the cart like this, and I was pushing them over to the golem farm, And if they got out of my render distance and I came back into render distance of them inside the cart, they would be outside the cart again. So I'd have to log out of Minecraft and log back in, and they were back in the cart again. But it really is a lot harder to deal with villagers and carts. So I might as well show you what I did to rectify the solution. Don't mind me. Boats. Yes, that's right. You can get them in boats like this. So what I did, they won't suffocate in the glass. So I get them in a boat. Butcher, I don't need anything from the butcher. Clerics, I already got the enchant I want with the cleric. So, okay, these two guys are useless. So I break the boat, and I get them out. And I try and get them a little bit away just because of the sweep attack with the sword. And I go, sorry, you're useless. Bye. I'm not going to need you for anything. Because as you see, if I sweep attack, it sometimes hurts the other guy in there. We don't want to do that. So I am just waiting for some more villagers to be brought down. It looks like there's some two or three babies up there right now. And I'm going to go through them and find the best ones. But the ones that are perfect buyers are over here. So I stole some blocks from the temple and decided to make a little villager guardian pods here with the colors of the guardians. Same colors, been done tons before, but orange for some reason works awesome with these blocks. So this guy, this is the perfect farmer. He has 18 wheat, which is the lowest you can go, 15 potatoes, lowest you can go, 15 carrots, lowest you can go. So this guy buys wheat, potato, carrots. With him alone, you should be able to get enough emeralds to be able to trade for any of these books over there. Just in case this guy gets locked up or you're low on those supplies, you can come over here and this guy buys rotten flesh. 36 is the lowest you gotta sell to get an emerald. So I kept this guy because he's pretty easy peasy. Less rotten flesh than any other thing. And I have that sky spawner that Mumbo Jumbo likes to make. So I have rotten flesh up the yin yang, so it's kind of like trash for emeralds. And if I have problems with those two, I also have the guy with the best paper trade, which is 24. So guess what? I can trade him paper, and because I got this excellent farm over there, I have enough paper to always get enough emeralds for me to buy the enchants I want in the books. Plus, as a kicker, this guy has the Efficiency 3 book and the Luck of the Sea 3 book, which is good. So more of the perfect non-book sales is this cleric just happens to have the best redstone, the best lapis, and the best glowstone deal that you can get in the game, which if you don't know, it's 4 redstone, 2, and 5. 3. Oh, that's right. 5 is the best glass. 3 is the best glowstone. So I put him in the center as an important dude because it's the ones that are going to stay to the side are the book ones, and the ones in the center are the ones that you can buy goods and supplies from. And Ender Pearls, seeing I do not have an Ender Pearl farm, I haven't even gone to the Nether, don't even know where there's a stronghold yet, and that will be a short yet, because I will soon. So yes, I'm going to be going to the end at some point in the near future. But anyways, best seller of Ender Pearls, 4. So 4 emeralds equals an Ender Pearl, that's the best deal you can get. And in the back here is the wall of the armorer and the other diamond garb that you can buy. There's 4 things that you possibly would want. All of these guys only have the enchants between levels 5 and 19 in their deals. So you can't get like efficiency 5 diamond pick. The best you can do is efficiency 3 diamond pick. So, but you buy 2 of them, you combine them, you got an efficiency 4. Not bad. Same with the diamond axe, efficiency 3 diamond axe. You combine 2 of them, you got your efficiency 4. I mean, that's what we use, so, or at least I use. And so yeah, I kind of like that deal. The only problem with this setup over here is there's some redstone from my etho door showing, and I don't really know how to cover that up without ruining the etho door or whatever. I mean, I could redo the redstone a little bit and make it fit, but it's, to me, it's my world. You're not really gonna see it unless I point it out like I just did. So I can deal with that. Now, the last two guys in the center, I'm not 100% sure if you can get protection 3 or sharpness 3 on the diamond chest piece and the diamond sword. So I'm still going through, what is this, a weaponsmith and an armorer, just in case I can get that sharpness 3 and that protection 3. But I'm not sure if that is a thing you can get, because like I said, these guys only give you the enchant of levels 5 through 19, and I'm not sure if level 19 you can get a sharpness 3 or a protection 3. But just in case, I'm still going through the trading process with those guys. So these are the guys that I can buy my diamond stuff from. These are the guys that I can buy, basic redstone, lapis, and other stuff, glowstone, ender pearls. And these are the guys that I, these three guys are the ones I use to get ender pearls. So with all that trading, the guys with the books are going to end up being against this wall. And I found out early on that when the wall is at the same height as the ground outside, which happens like right over here, zombies can kill these guys through that little crevice there. So there it's underground on the outside there, so it's okay. So you got to be careful, or at least I got to be careful in here for that. So some of the books that I have received already, and there really isn't any others I was looking for. I was mainly looking for this guy. This guy was one of the last ones I just got. So I'm just going to do a couple more rounds of breeding with the villagers. Then I'm going to stop trying to get better villagers, and I'll figure out some sort of display area in here that I'm going to do. I was thinking of maybe doing the acacia wood, keeping the orange and green going, but I'm not sure yet. So these pods might be very close to the pods out here. But some of the things I've got, I got a looting 3, aqua affinity, infinity, thorns 3, Mr. God right there, depth strider 3, which is always nice to have around, frostwalker, I just have them just because I've never played with frostwalker. Don't think I really use frostwalker that much, but one episode to play with it, it might be fun. Smite 5, bane of arthropods 5. I don't normally keep these guys, but this guy, to go along with a looting 3 would be great for a nether skeleton skull hunter type sword. Yeah. This guy's got the lore 3, silk trust, respiration 3. So he's got the perfect glass sail, so I can get 5 glass for 1 emerald, and the sharpness 4, which is pretty awesome. Sky Fortune 2 and the Unbreaking 3. He's a huge, Unbreaking 3 is a huge guy to get also. I'm going to go to sleep. I'll be right back. So the other day when I was doing, made that video and I showed you probably about 8 hours of me just digging stuff out, I spent 2 to 3 hours working on this. And also I decided to start doing a beautification project on my property. I've done a lot of work because I've been home now with the injury I have, and I'm going to be home for a while, so there may be a lot of work in between each one of these episodes. Now, first off, I wanted to show you over here. I needed this to look okay, so I made this back flat wall, prismarine also, with the orange glass. I think I'm going to just change those, this block over to this block. I don't know what the difference in the names are. Okay, prismarine to prismarine bricks. So, oops. Gotta figure out how to use these keyboard commands after playing this game for 6 years or so. Yeah, so that block right there will be a prismarine brick. Same with that one. It just doesn't look right from the outside. And I'll show you right now what I'm talking about. So let's go sneaky outside this way. I put some torches down and melted some of the snow because I would much rather see walkway than snow. Yeah, so this is what it looks like from the outside. So you can see it would look better if it was six prismarine bricks instead of that one right there. So I am going to change that out. So don't worry about that. But we got this golem farm that I have to show you. But I also did a beautification project to go towards the golem farm. So I'll just show you that also as we go. So this before was just a little ice walkway. I added it, made it a little bit wider, added some packed ice in here just to give it a little bit of a change. And I don't, it kind of beats making a bridge here. I don't know. I made it so I didn't have to lose my sprint by putting all these places, all these half slabs where stairs would be going or whatever. So I don't have to jump up these things anymore. So because I like to sprint around everywhere, and I hate losing my sprint because I walked into a block by accident. So I made this pathway. I used the new path block and I made some pathway going over here, and I tried to beautify it so I can get to my farms. Okay, then the pathway also comes up here and goes straight up here to go to my cactus farm, which I'm gonna have to be turning off soon because I am filled. How filled am I? I am filled to the brim with cactus. So this cactus farm might even be going bye-bye or hidden someplace else. So I also made the project go this way, and I made this bridge. Let's see what the bridge looks like from the side before I go over it. I just came up with this design, made it as I went along. It's just a normal bridge, except for the angle that the bridge is. So it's kind of weird because it's not, it's kind of random, but I kind of like it. I didn't want it to be a normal bridge because I was coming from over on this side of the thing and I wanted to end up over there a little bit. So it's like moved over 7 or 8 blocks. So if I went diagonally, it would have been moved over like 15 blocks. But this way I can just, it's just, I don't know. It's weird, but I like it. So that's what my, that's all that matters. I like it, so I'm gonna keep it. And initially, the bridge was just an excuse to get over to the Iron Golem Farm. But I decided running over to the Iron Golem Farm, it would be kind of cool to have a house here. So this is up here. I'm working on it right now as we speak. I'm in the middle process. I'm building my house. This is where my bed will be and my actual spawn house. So I'm going to have the half slabs coming up here, so I'm going to have to take out some of this hill to make it smoother to go up, but there's going to be a path coming up here. And as you see, I did the hidden lighting thing that everybody's done, because this whole path on the way to the golem farm is lit up by hidden lighting. There's some light down there. There's some probably light up here somewhere. Yep, over here. So, this path I made, beautified, maybe a little bit overkill on the grass, but I kind of like that. All the way out to the Iron Golem Farm, which is kicking some butt. So I still use the half slabs because I'm running. And there's lights, yeah, hidden in places still. I was thinking of doing that lit tree thing, taking off the top leaves of all these trees around here and putting glowstone up there. But honestly, I don't have that much glowstone anymore, and I hate going for it, so I'm going to say, I'll put that one on hold for a little while. So we come up to the golem farm, and ultimately, these things are as ugly as sin, and I want to cover this thing up. Would eventually get rid of this stair ladder thing here, and then I'd have that thing just floating up there, but man, you know, I don't really want to do that, so we'll see. And I also gotta pay attention to this because I just added some doors to my house over there, and I don't want that to mess up my obsidian, my villager thing. So this is a certain amount of time, and I've taken 4 or 5 stacks out of this already. So I gotta remember what 23 poppies. Because I just want to make sure this thing's still working. I figured with all the talking I've done over here, it probably would have seen one fall down for now. And as you see by the amount of chests I have here, I expect to be doing this world for a long time. And as you saw over here, there was hidden lighting. So I hid the lighting all over the place. Oh, and there's one more thing I wanted to show you before I left. And everybody who has a has a world that they like to play with should make one of these. Yeah, what I was talking about with if that is broken. I added a couple of doors here, and I don't know if that's going to interfere with that farm. And it might even interfere with that farm over there. So I'm keeping a close eye. I just put these doors on a minute ago. So I'm going to keep a close eye and make sure it doesn't slow down the productivity. And on my villager breeder, what I do is when they stop breeding, I have this four quad thing of carrots over here. When they're all grown up, I take all the carrots, I farm them all down, I get 8 to 10 stacks, and I replant more carrots. I bring them over to the villagers, and I throw them into the top booth of the villagers, the breeding villagers. And about an hour or so later, I'll have 20 or so new villagers to go through. But now once they go through all the food, they'll stop breeding at that speed. So I'm going to take another quick nap, and I'll show you that last little thing I've worked on. All right, so the last thing that I have made for my world that everybody should make in their own world is one of these Panda 4994 AFK farms. This is the old version of it. It's a lot bigger than the new version that he just came out with. Either version works just as well, but the newer version is a bit better size requirement and all that, and it's probably a little bit easier to make, but I'm not sure. I've never made one. So basically, you stand here, you turn that thing on, it flicks out. I'm supposed to have a door here. I don't have a door here because of all the villager stuff I have going around. There's my door, okay? You turn it on, and this thing spits out fishing rods at you. So you need your inventory to be full before you begin this. The door continues to open, and this continues to shoot fishing rods at you. So with your inventory full, if you stand here and just right click, when the door opens, it allows you to cast, okay? The bobber is in between. You see the trap hook things up there? There's a string in between there. The bobber, even though it does not look like it is, it's actually in between that string, which is keeping the door from closed and also keeping this dropper in front of me from dropping me fishing poles. So as soon as I catch something, the trip wires stop being given signal, and the door opens again, and the thing kicks out another fishing rod, just in case I broke my fishing rod. And in this way, if you do have a fishing rod with mending, which I do somewhere, I might have lost it, I don't know, it should have been in this dropper, and this dropper happened to be empty when I started doing this. You can continue fishing with the same fishing pole. I'm going to turn this stuff off. I'm going to reel it in. So what happens? You catch something, you bring it towards you, your inventory is full, the thing falls into the dropper, and it goes into a big hopper chain thing over here. I love my door. So whenever I'm done, I just throw my rods in there, and they go back into this chain and back into this dropper. So, but once you get that fishing pole that you cannot replace because it's so awesome, you don't really need this dropper thing, and you can just stand here and fish. So to give you an idea, I've done a couple of overnight sessions, and this isn't all the things I've done. I would say in an overnight session, this is where all the stuff lands. I can fill up 3 chests. So I've gone through it a couple of times for the chests, and I kind of separated some of the things into chests here for future references. But I don't really need to do this anymore after doing 3 overnight sessions. Here's my fishing poles. You'll have a bunch in here with mending, lore 3, and you know, I can add this, unbreaking, mending, lore 3, and there's got to be a luck of the sea 3 in here that I can just add to it, and then I have that perfect fishing pole that I can never. So even though I lost one, it's not a big deal that I lost one. I got a double chest of saddles here's all the extra fish I've gotten. You know, I can make as many water breathing potions as I possibly can. I have name tags up the yin yang. Everything else, I mean, I even have a stack and a half of the clownfish bows up the yin yang. And not, you know, level one enchanted type bows, but high mending bows. You know, and they also come with mending a lot. So, that's how, who did it? Exuma made his fortune on the newest Hermitcraft series because he made a whole bunch of mending bows early on in the game. Because you get mending bows doing this. And, you know, books. I've used some of the books. And these aren't low-level books either. These are all kick-ass mother-effing books. So, this thing is definitely good. The last overnighter I did, I haven't even had time to go through the loot, but this is kind of what the loot looks like. I just chucked these because, you know, how many leather boots can you really have in your life? I have fish for days. Fish doesn't feed you well as meat and stuff, but it does a good job. Whenever I hear zombies, I get worried. So I'm not 100% sure all of this is 100% zombie proof yet. And of course, like an idiot, I tend to, when I'm doing this, forget to cover them back up again, because right now little babies can eat their faces. Get in the corner there. Thank you. I'm really not worried about hurting these guys anymore, because I have so many of them, and I basically have everybody I want. So basically, what my future entails for me is a good way to store these villagers that I'm going to buy the books from on the walls here. These guys are all going to be how it is. My other future project, probably all be done before the next episode, is I'm going to finish this house over here. And something else. Well, I don't remember what something else was. I want to make sure that the that thing's still working. We can find out right now. Something should have dropped by now. And then I'm going to let you go for the day. But, yeah, I'll let you know what the house looks like when it's done in the next episode, and I'll show you the design I came up for holding the villagers that sell the books. I'm going to keep up against the wall. So let's see if I have extra. I don't remember what was in here before, but I think if I saw it, I think there was 23 poppy. Let's see. 25. So I think, that definitely went up a little bit. So I don't think my doors over here on this house is really bugging the farm. It's been a great day. I'm glad you liked the show. And if you did, please hit the like button, say hi, comment to me, have me have any questions. Let me know if you want the world seed for this in episode 25. I think this is episode 23, so I can release a world seed in episode 25, but I've never really been one of those types of people who have seen, oh my god, this is the world seed for Ethos world, let's go check it out and see what it looked like beforehand. It's like, yeah, I don't know, it's never been a big deal to me for world seeds. I kind of like world tours, and it's still a little too early for a world tour, but we'll see. Have a great day. Glad you enjoyed the show. It's Keith for KMA's Corner, and I'll be back next week. Goodbye.